It's an absolutely spectacular relief compared with any other site you ever ever see. Something on it. Okay, does that make sense?
That's good.
So, quite large specimens, and you see another one here, another one here, one over here, and then here's a rod with bristles on it, undescribed. Olazoan, elephant skin, quite beautiful elephant skin. Remember, with elephant skin, you're looking at a cast of the bottom. So if I was to press down on here and turn this up, that's what elephant skin looks like on the sea floor. And we imagine that's some kind of cyanobacterial coat, the sort of thing that you'd find on a very badly maintained freshwater aquarium if you didn't have snails eating the bottom. It's unlikely to be some kind of loading because these are sand sitting on sand. And the only separator is this organic material and all of these individual organisms. So we think that's actually some of the original microbial mat pattern. So elephant skin, micropucker, then all these tubular fossils, body fossils of these three-armed things called tribrachidium, other unnamed structures, pits. There's a whole array of things that you can get when you put the slabs back together again and start to look at what things occur together. Now we can start to talk about these in terms of clustering and in terms of what sorts of organisms were associated on a particular seafloor and compare them to other beds at different levels.